Hi, welcome back. We are now in my studio and I'm going to talk about making a picture book dummy. The first thing that I do is I take those thumbnails that we've been working on and I take them a step farther. I take them past the stick figure stage and I really work on what I want each spread to look like. And this is a really, really fun stage. I plan the scenes and I can look at my entire picture book in one place. That's the wonderful thing about storyboards. And as I do that, I look for variety. I look for differences in perspective. For example, I want some of my spreads to be viewed from way up high and some from underneath. I look for a variety of close-ups and pullbacks. I also look to see that the words and what I'm proposing to draw are really intertwined. So if a scene is very active and the words are very active, then I want to be sure that what I'm planning to draw for that spread is also very active. And if it's a very still scene, I want to be sure that that's what I've drawn to. But this is the stage where I really plan what I want my final sketches to look like. And I get everything where I can see it, and then I move on to the next phase, which is the sketching phase. Now I start the sketching phase. I'm old-fashioned, I use pencil and paper, and I start sketching what I've drawn on the thumbnails. The next thing I do after I've got some sketches is I take my sketch, and thank you, camera person, for following me, and I scan in my sketches into my computer, and then I do a lot of editing digitally with my Wacom tablet. I can manipulate characters around, I can move backgrounds in and out, I can pull in close up, pull it back, but I do a lot of planning digitally from my sketches that I've scanned in. I also, once I've scanned in the sketches, I add things and draw with my tablet, but I do a whole lot of planning and editing digitally on my computer once I've got my sketches drawn with pencil and paper. And I have to say, I just absolutely love this thing. I can do really, really cool stuff like this. I go ahead and work up 2-page spreads for all of my sketches. I put the words on. I spend a lot of time playing around, moving things around. And then when I'm finished, I put all of my 2-page spreads together into one big PDF and I print it up. When I print up my book dummy, I use legal size paper. I print it up and it looks like this. I cannot tell you how great it is to see your work printed up. All kinds of things are going to jump out at you that you're going to need to change. So this is another place to revise. But this is basically what it's going to look like when you've printed it. And this is what you're going to submit to an agent or an editor, unless they want a digital submission. And in that case, you'll send a PDF file of your book dummy. Okay, so the very last thing you're going to want to do after you've gotten your manuscript perfect, your sketches are done, your picture book dummy is finished, then you're going to want to do 1 or 2 spreads painted or in full color, whatever your final style is, to submit with your work to an editor or an agent. And you are finished! I think of
about it over and over again. I replay it over and over again. And I can't take it, yeah. I can't shake it.
So thanks so much for being here today. And best of luck with your own projects. If anybody has a question, I know I covered a lot really fast, and I just sort of hit the highlights. But if anybody has a specific question or wants me to address something a little more in depth, I'm happy to answer questions at sfhardy@sfhardy.com. And thanks again. Yay, finished.